عنده معلومات عنه او شافه او عمل بيه اكزامينيشن قبل كده او جاله ريبورت حتى؟ في حد عنده اي خبره عن اليو بي ام؟ يعني حد شاف الريبورت او شاف الجهاز او شاف العيان بيتعمله ازاي؟ عندكم فعلا معلومات عن كده؟ تمام. احنا كده انا بس خد بس فكره عن الشباب بيقولوا ايه. في برينت اوت للصور دي لو حد حابب يبقى شايف الصورة عن قرب كده بس هنوزعها دلوقتي.
نوزعها قبل ايه رأيك؟
Second one, it is a probe of ultrasound. Third one, the probe of oil A scan, which is examined used to examination and measurement of axial lens. This is the position of the patient using local anesthesia and putting the eye cup. These eye cups, it with multiple sizes, it's 5 to 6 cups, used in different condition, in children, in large eyes, in small eyes. Then we fold this cup with methyl cellulose or any viscous material or lubricant to coat the cornea and prevent any trauma للتيشوز بتاعت العين. Then we'll fold it with distilled water and starting the examination. We can monitor the photo we see it on the screen in front on us during we doing the examination. At the first ultrasound, ultrasound biomicroscopy or the UBM, it's a technique used primary for imaging of anterior segment of the eye. What's the difference between the ultrasound of A scan and B scan and the ultrasound of anterior segment ultrasound? It's different for the megahertz or the oscillatory potential what's used to examine anterior segment and examine the posterior segment. Ultrasound biomicroscopy resolution up to 20 micrometer axially and 50 micrometer laterally, and its depth of tissue penetration 4 to 5 millimeter. It means that it is with good resolution and good penetration and wide field. This is the normal photo for UBM in examination of the angle. You can see here the cornea. I can see the corneal layer. I can see the endothelium. I can see the thickness of the cornea and measure it also. I can see the internal reflectivity if the cornea is clear or if there is any opacities or any edema. I can see also the anterior chamber and anterior chamber depth, anterior chamber content. I can examine and see the angle with Schlemm's canal and Schlemm's line and depth of the angle and measure it, and also see the scleral pair, pars plana, pars plicata, ciliary body, and the iris contour and the iris shape. Also, I can see the anterior surface of the lens and also the posterior capsule and anterior vitreous phase in the good resolution in new machines. Again, this is the structure what I can see in the UBM and do examination for it. What is the difference between UBM and anterior segment OCT? Dr. Noha explain it very good, and I will explain it again. The anterior segment OCT, it is very good resolution. The patient is standing in upright position. There is no contact between the probe and the eye. There is no water path or any trauma in the tissues. It's very rapid with good resolution. There is no artifact. But there is very, very big problem. If there is the patient is a child, it is not cooperative. He can't stand on putting his chin in the machine. Also, if there is corneal opacity, this is the big problem. I wanted to know what's behind this corneal opacity. So UPM solves this problem. It is with average resolution. I can examine the patient in supine position. children under light anesthesia. Also, I can examine structure behind the iris. I can see the lens and measure the axial length of the lens. See the posterior capsule if it is intact or not. I can see the ciliary body and the zonules. I can see the zonules if any subluxation or loss of zonodialysis. I can see it and measure it in the clock hours. UBM examination, here we have again, the same technique, how to examine UBM examination technique similar to B-mode ultrasound, transducer direction and the manipulation of the probe is guided by looking at the image on the screen. The major difference include an oscillating probe without covering and the use of water path, fine movement is required. The patient is examined in supine position facing ceiling, topical anesthesia is put, or eye cups is used. Putting the viscous like methyl cellulose and water bath with our normal saline. This is a probe of the UBM. It is uncovered oscillatory part. It is moved. Oscillatory motility motions it appear in the examination in water bath. Move like this. So if the eye is opened in any trauma or any sutures or any abscess or infection in the eye, I couldn't do the UBM. I couldn't do this examination in opened eye, trauma, or abscess, or any infection. Again, this is the machine, this is the probes, this is the position of the patient, and this is the last photo I see in the screen. This is the position and screen in front of me, and foot switch, I can measure any distance I need. I would foot switch, I stop, and then take a photo, and a video is recorded. Again, this is a normal normal photo for a normal anterior segment ultrasound. Like any ultrasound, there is probe orientation. Here, there is three orientation in UBM. Axial scan, longitudinal or radial scans, and the transverse scans. The axial scan, place the probe perpendicular to the cornea in the center of the pupil. What the landmark on the probe facing superiorly or nasally. Okay, I take a figure. This figure will be show me or make me examine the cornea with its layers, examine anterior chamber with content, with depth. I can see also the iris contour and anterior capsule and posterior capsule in central area. Radial or longitudinal scans place the probe perpendicular to the limbus, directed the landmark on the probe towards the pupil. I examine here clock hour per clock hour. I examine the 6 o'clock hour, so I see the angle in 6 o'clock hour. And in contrast to ultrasound, I examine the opposite point to the probe. No, it is under my hand, yes, this is the site of the lesion, yes, okay, at 6 o'clock, it is longitudinal 6 o'clock hour, this is the lesion, the angle measuring how much degree I put it in this angle. I move around the limbus and measure all the angle and all the circumference. I can examine in this scan the angle with the scleral pair and ciliary body. I can see the root of the iris. This is the angle. Okay. This is the most common scan I use in UBM. Transverse scan, it is also examined by clock hours. The probe is placed parallel to the limbus over the center of the iris at the clock hour of interest. So I examine the root of the iris and also the birth plan and ciliary body and cilia process. يعني أنا هحرك إيدي بس البرة شوية فحبدأ أشوف الحاجات اللي وراء الأنجل. So again, this is the normal shape of the angle of seen by UBM. Yes, it is the, this is the resolution I can see. I will show you a photo in our machine. This is good, very good resolution. I can see the ligament, I can see the ciliary sulcus, I can see the ciliary process, I can see until to the anterior vitreous phase and posterior capsule. Again, this is a normal photo, علشان نبقى متعودين على المنظر, عشان لما نشوف في حاجة فيها abnormality نقدر نلقطها. نفس القصة، أنا هنا هو بقيس كورنيال ثيكنس بالكاليبر، بقيس الانتيرير تشامبر قد كام مليمتر، بقيس الانجل كام ديجري، بشوف الكونتور بتاع الايرس، بشوف الكونتور بتاع الانجل، وبشوف الكونتور بتاع دي هنا في اي او ال ودي باج، انا شايفه البوستير كبسول، انا شايفه البوستير كبسول، انا شايفه الباك كلها، شايفه الزنيولز قدامي مرسومه والسيلياري بادي مرسوم وكل حاجه باينه قدامي لغايه ورق ويز جود ريزولوشن. There is other quantitative parameter of UBM but it's more complicated but I can measure if I need it. Now we're starting to apply the UBM. The most common examination I need UBM in it is glaucoma. It is examination for the angle. Mainly the UBM examines the angle. There is no other machine can examine the angle very good like the UBM. Especially if the patient is young, the like children, there is difficult examination on the slit lamp. I must يعني ان العيان ينام لازم البيبي ده ينام واعمل له examination. هعمل له examination by light anesthesia، بحط البروب بتاعي واحط الكون بتاعي واقدر اكزامن زي ما انا عايزه واشوف كل حاجه والدكتور بتاعه يشوف فيديو مصور للانجل بتاع البيشنت ده. اول حاجه هنقدر نشوفها هنا this is the angle. It is not open angle here. This is the angle. This is the iris tissue. Pushed anteriorly against the trabecular meshwork and closing it. So there is interference of aqueous outflow. Okay, this the figure after doing a iodectomy, this opening of this angle and the aqueous outflow come out. Okay, this is the problem solved. UBM also can see examine the angle recession glaucoma. Angle recession is a regular angle. It's recessed behind the normal site. This is مفروض يعني دي الانجل القديمة مفروض تكون acute angle. No, it is irregular angle and recessed behind the normal site of the angle. Also in the iris plateau iris for explanation the plateau iris there is a large ciliary body misdirected. It is pushed the iris anteriorly and closing the angle. This is angle very narrow, very narrow, pushed by last a large ciliary body and ciliary body directed anteriorly. This is also in very interesting cases. This is a pigment dispersion syndrome. This is لو احنا عايزين نشوف هنا ده الجهاز فعلا اللي احنا شغالين عليه، دي صورة عيان فعلا. في الاكثر حاجه مشهوره في البيجمنت ديسبيرشن سندروم ديب انتيرير تشامبر اوبن وايدلي اوبن انجل، انجل هنا 50 ديجري تقريبا with back bowing of the iris touching the lens and touching the zonules making the pigment cells is liberating in the anterior chamber closing the angle and elevated intraocular pressure. This is the photo of the patient on the slit lamp seeing that there is a slit-like retroillumination defect in pigment dispersion. This is the patient after a briefer iodotomy. There is a straightening of the iris. This is different. يعني there is صورة اتحسنت جدا بعد ما عملنا iodotomy، حصل straightening للiris وبقت getting away from the lens and the nodes. Also in follow-up patient after subscleral trabeculectomy with follow-up of filtering bleb if it is this is the surgery successful or not. I can see here the filtering bleb. This is conjunctiva filtering bleb. The aqueous outflow through the sclera is ostium. There is also patent ostium here and anterior open to the anterior chamber and aqueous collected under the filtering bleb. In hypermetropia or in short axial lens, there is large lens pushing the iris anteriorly, making the anterior chamber is shallow. Here I can see the anterior chamber depth 2.5 millimeter, the angle around 17 to 14 degree. It is very shallow and the patient is going to suffering from interrupted increased intraocular pressure. Also there is in large lens, I can see here 4 millimeter or 3.9 millimeter lens, making the lens iris is pushed anteriorly and causing iris bombay. This is very exaggerated. Actually, this patient in acute congestive glaucoma now. In uveitic patients, also there is thickened cornea. This is cornea is very edematous. Anterior chamber contains cells. Briefer anterior synechia causing closing to the angle and or circumferences. Also, there is iris bombae. Under the iris, I can see the iris nodules. This granulomatous anterior uveitis. Then this patient after injection, we can see the difference between this photo and this photo. The patient, okay, there is present the synechia, but the iris nodules is improved جدا واحنا بدأنا نشوف ان الدنيا بقت الكورنيا حتى بقت كوايت وما بقتش ايديمتا زي الاول. In occlusive uveal and juvenile arthritis patient in babies complaining from the band keratopathy, I can also examine the anterior chamber and giving the picture of what's behind of this corneal opacity. Also we can see membrane closing the iris and causing the posterior synechia around the pupil to the anterior surface of the lens. In microphthalmic eye with short axial lens, we can see the IOL master of this patient with axial lens 16. High error of refraction, high hypermetropia. This patient need IOL 45 diopter to correct this hypermetropia. Her surgeon decided to do implantation of two IOLs, one of them in the sulcus and the other in the bag. And this is patient's very lucky, and she is complaining from posterior microphthalmia. This is deep anterior chamber with open angle. And here we can see the first IOL in the sulcus, and behind it in the bag, other IOL. Okay, with deep anterior chamber, open angle, and the iris in normal position. Also, limbal masses or corneal masses or iris masses, ciliary body masses, we can examine the patient with large fleshy lesion covering the cornea, passing the cyst. مفيش أي فحص في الدنيا هيقدر يطلع السيست دي غير اليوبيم. مفيش أي حاجة. Anterior segment حتى لو في clear cornea. Clear cornea patient complaining for increased intraocular pressure ممكن يكون عنده cells وفلير واحنا مش عارفين السبب جاي منين والعيان بالنسبة لي كويت جدا لما أعمل له UPM هشوف الزيليز large cystic lesion I read ciliary بين الأيرس وبين الciliary body ممكن نشوف tumors كمان مش بس cyst. In post trauma also this patient I wanted to examine him what is behind this corneal opacity. Where is the iris? Where is the iris? Where is the cornea? Where is the anterior chamber? This is the cornea with increased internal refractivity, corneal scar. The iris, this is the second area of the iris, is adhesive in back surface of the cornea. It is adherent to the back surface of the cornea, amalgamated with the lens, subluxated, and hinged up by membranes in the back of the iris, in the back of the cornea. Also, in traumatic rupture of anterior capsule. This is the cornea with corneal wound, interrupted sutures appear in the anterior chamber, with anterior chamber is irregular in depth. This is the angle is opened in all circumferences, but there is a fluffy material occluding it. This iris is elevated. The zonules is intact and stretched. Yes, this is the zonules. Posterior capsule is intact, and there is rupture of anterior capsule, and the lens material, fluffy lens material emerged from the anterior capsule and falling the anterior chamber, doing a very severe reaction. Posterior capsule. Anterior capsule opened, it is cataractous traumatic lens. The nules is seen, ciliary body, anterior chamber, with few materials then falling the occluding the angle. After perforating corneal or infected perforated corneal ulcer, we can see here thinning. The cornea with increased internal refractivity, okay, this is the opaque cornea with a small thinned area. It is the old scar or old healed perforated corneal ulcer. when the perforation happened, all the content of the eye is pushed anteriorly and adhere behind the cornea. A regular anterior chamber with membrane extending to the anterior surface of the subluxated lens, also cataractous lens, and also the iris is adherent to the back of the cornea. There is surprises happen when I examine any patient with corneal opacity with multiple surgery. He changed his doctor. راح لدكتور جديد، الدكتور مش عارف ايه اللي حصل له، عمال يقول بقى ده انا جالي يا ده عملت ميه بيضاء، ده انا عملت جلوكوما، احنا مش عارفين ايه اللي حصل، طب الدكتور عايز يعمل له كراتوبلاستي. دو يو بي ام. This is very thick cornea with opaque cornea with IOL in the back of the cornea. There is no iris, no iris tissue. Maybe removed, you may traumatized. Also there is drainage, glaucoma drainage implant, tube of valve. In refractive surgery, دلوقتي بقى كل الناس بتحط ارتزان وبتحط اي سي ال وبتحط اي سي ال وعايزه تشوف انا حطيتها صح ولا غلط، العيان جاي بيشتكي عنده بيجمنت سيلز في الانتيرو تشامبر، انا مش عارفه جت منين، طيب نعمل اكزامينيشن لليو بي ام ونبدا نقيس حاجه اسمها الفولت. الفولت is the distance between the اي سي ال and the crystalline lens. The اي سي ال is implanted in the sulcus. Okay? The suitable place, not touching the iris, not touching the crystalline lens. This is the volt ideally measured from 300 to 600 micrometer with foot plate in the sulcus, okay, and the IOL in the sulcus. It's away from the ciliary iris and away from the crystalline lens. Another ICL. Okay, خلاص احنا خلصت. The other one is barely touching the lens. Other one is very extensive vault. This is normal case. This is ICL in the suitable place. This is for funny. This is ICL inserted upside down. Okay, this is elevation of the iris. Anterior chamber is shallow with iris is looking up, not to down. It is inverted. When cataractous lens, it appear behind. It's causing trauma to the iris and the crystalline lens. At last, to summate, the UPM examines the anterior segment, is done for children on light anesthesia, can also examine the eye with corneal opacity, can examine the ocular structure behind the iris, like lens and ciliary body. Thank you.